La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, ma lana rabbun siwa. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha.
Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة صدق الله العظيم Distinguished President of today's program, Honorable Judges, Prominent Guests and Dear Audience, Today I have been given the honor to speak on the topic of Ideal Leader and Good Governance. Dear far-sighted audience, the world has reached a consensus that good governance is significant for human resource development in any society. In this context, the UNDP, IMF, World Bank, various NGOs, and numerous studies suggest that good governance primarily relies on the institutional infrastructure. The literature further accepts that the quality of leadership is also significant for good governance. The important principle of good governance is that the ruler must be sincere and of impeccable character. He must consider himself not a ruler but a servant. He should behave with restraint and avoid abuse of power. He should act within the parameters of the law and take upon himself the country's concerns and hardships. Beloved audience, the absence of honesty in any society often leads towards unethical practices. For example, our present-day society is in the grip of widespread corruption. A politician submits a fake degree to stay in elections. A police kills a person in a fake encounter. A businessman evades taxes. A builder uses outdated material. A teacher skims on class work in order to sell his time privately. And a doctor recommends a drug to gain commission from a pharmaceutical firm. So you can realize how much the concept of honesty is violated. The foundations of society are undermined and nation's future is ruined. Dear nation's brothers, the good governance is neither dependent on democracy nor infrastructure of institution. Rather, the primary determinant of good governance is the leader who is said responsible for establishing all the necessary systems. Therefore, the state should be governed by leaders committed to earning people's happiness through their actions and governance. Leaders committed with the welfare of the masses. The most significant and shining example of ideal leader is the personality of our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. When he became the head of the state of Medina, he exemplified good governance. He created a bond of brotherhood among the Muslim citizens, concluded agreements with non-Muslim. He upheld the Islamic value system in which justice remains central. He declared that all humans are the offspring of Adam and that there is no difference between Arab and non-Arab. The intellectuals, the enemies of Islam in Mecca were very cruel. But when Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, conquered Mecca, the companions of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, captured all the enemies and brought them to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, with the slogan, Al-Yawmu Yawmul Malhama, which means it is the day to take revenge upon the enemies. It is the day to tear the enemies apart. It is the day to kill the enemies. The enemies were those people who torture and abused the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. The enemies were those people who compelled the Prophet and his companions to leave Mecca. The enemies were those people who surrounded the Prophet and tried to assassinate him. And see, our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, reacted and responded to the slogan of his companions and said, Al-Yawmu Yawmul Marhama, which means it is the day to show mercy upon the enemies. It is the day not to torture the enemies. It is the day to forgive the enemies. Such a compassionate and forgiving leader, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was. Dear dignitaries, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in his lifetime itself has formed four dynamic, dedicated, determined and disciplined leaders who were Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar, Hazrat Uthman, Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhum. I would like to put light upon very efficient and good leadership skill of one of the disciples of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He ruled about 30 countries, and I say a few names: Iraq, Iran, Oman, Egypt, Syria, Jerusalem, etc. It's not easy to rule a state today, but Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu has ruled over the world, and he was well known for doing justice to every citizen of the states he ruled. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu issued 6 instructions to all the governors. The governors were answerable in case they failed to follow them. They were terminated if they were found wrong. The 6 instructions of good governance issued by Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu were: number 1, not to wear fashionable clothes. Number 2, not to eat delicious food, and which means not to have a variety of food at the same time. Number 3, to let the common people have easiest access to at the office. Number 4, to let office function 24 hours a day. Number 5, to attend the funeral ceremonies of the citizen of the states he ruled. Number 6, to visit the people who were taken ill. Dear brethren, is anybody in the world can name the leader who has ruled over the world but won't torn clothes with patches on them? Is there any leader in the world who carried cans of drinking water on his shoulder for poor and widowed women? Is there any leader in the world who visited the places alone without being escorted by bodyguard? It was Hazrat Umar. That's why Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, in one of his articles not only praised Caliph Umar but also said India needed a leader like him. Writing in Harijan, published on 27 July 1937, Gandhiji advised his fellow congressmen of leading a life of simplicity in this fashion: I cannot present before you the examples of Sri Ramchandra and Sri Krishna, as they are not personalities recognized by history. I cannot help but present to you names of Abu Bakr and Umar. They were leaders of a vast empire, yet they lived a life of austerity. Dear friends, in short, people cannot make progress unless they follow this principle of good governance. No nation can dream of development without good governance. If you want to prosper and succeed, we will have to consider the recently discussed facts, try to eliminate our shortcomings, and establish good governance without further delay. Here I terminate my talk with this prayer: that Allah make the country prosperous and give us tawfiq to bring them into practices. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Eastern Crescent is not just an English monthly, but differs from others in many ways. It consists of well-researched articles, targets issues which seldom get the attention of the mainstream media, gives every issue its deserving place, answers the misconceptions about Islam and Muslims, acts aptly on its slogan, Alternative Media, People's Choice. For subscription and other details, please contact us on 022-2677-1618 or 022-2679-8538. You may also log on to www.easterncrescent.in.